Lakers Nation, welcome back to Let's Be Honest. Yo, I'm your host, Pretty Shy. Look, Vitaly and Amita have been calling me, telling me the ladies been missing me. I'm back. I know I'm back. Look, people, exciting stuff. We got Steve Nash in the house. Now, look, you know I'm excited? This guy gave Marcin Gortat. Let me say that again. Marcin Gortat. That sounds like a mafioso Russian name. He shouldn't be playing basketball. He shot 56%. Yes, he did. 56%. You know what I'm talking about, the dude with the long nose? I'm telling you, that's going to be pretty good. And wait, who's he have? Bynum and Gasol? Aw, but do you know why Steve Nash is good? Look, this guy averages more than 8.6 assists a game. Why is that a big fact? Since 1996, Kobe's never played with a guy who's averaged more than 8.6 assists a game. You got some help, people.
Me, Kobe, we're in another stratosphere. I hear people talk about me so much, and I forget. You know, I really am great. I'm just like you, but 10 times better.
Lakers Nation, let's break this deal down. If you're not in the triangle offense, you have to have a true point guard. We finally got one. Took a minute since 96. It took a while, but we did it. Now, people, look, this is why I like him. He's Canadian. He's a socialist. That's why he likes to spread the wealth, baby. He likes it to go. He agrees with Obama's healthcare plan, if you know what I'm talking about. He likes to pass the ball. He's going to get it to Bynum. He's going to get it to Gasol. He's going to get inside the paint. What does that solve? Well, what? Bynum's not going to whine anymore because he gets the ball in his hand. Kobe doesn't have to set up all the plays. He can actually work off the ball. He can concentrate his energy on defending because he's the best defender we have on the team. Mike Brown's defense is going to be team defense. It doesn't even need to be individual defense. Now, look, I'm not going to be able to keep up with Westbrook, but no one can keep up with Westbrook. So that's cool. What we need to do is get rid of Meta World Peace and make our bench stronger. And I think we got a championship team, people. I think we're ready to roll. We're going to take over the West. As long as Durant doesn't get better, breaks a knee or something.
It's like, you know, people say, hey, you don't want to swim with sharks, but I'm faster than sharks, so it's not a big deal.
Look, people, Lakers Nation, pretty sure. I got insider information. Now, people asking, how is this guy 38 and he plays like he's 30? Because he's half black. I said it. I know that for a fact. Now, people ask, how do you know he's half black? He doesn't look half black. Watch this as proof. Look at this.
So I thought I would make a little video here to prove him wrong. Check it out.
That's like, that's 10, 11 inches. Easily. And that's in the middle of the night. That was just from a dream. Can you imagine in person? That's a dream right there. I don't want to see that thing when we hold up our 17th title, okay? Woo! Now, people, look, don't take this for granted because we got lucky. Word was Mark Cuban was going after Steve Nash. Now, everyone knows he played with Nowitzki. They're really good friends. So Lakers really didn't have a chance, but we didn't give up. Look, this is what happens, people. You ever broken up with a girlfriend and try to get her back? Like, you break up with her because you're like, dude, she's ugly. And then you see her 5 years later, you're like, dang, she got really hot. That's an awkward conversation, isn't it? That was pretty awkward for Mark Cuban. It's like, you know, a couple years ago, my bad. It's not a big deal. It wasn't you, it was just me. See, what happened was, is I had found God, and will you get back with me? And Steve Nash was like, no. I don't like 7 foot Germans that don't dress well. I've met Nowitzki. His style is whack. Okay, I met him in Australia. He had a sweater and jeans and shorts at a club. I was like, dude, what are you doing? You can't have 5'10" bodyguards when you're 7 feet tall. What's wrong with you? That's a weird dude. Mark Cuban doesn't even concentrate on his team. He's watching Shark Tank. He's on it. Look, we want to keep it simple. Everyone's wondering, how's Nash's transition to LA going to be? I think he fits right in.
I'm always searching for the next opportunity to prove to myself and others that I've got what it takes. That I can go one better.
That was my parking spot.
Really?
That was my parking spot.
I feel these lessons breed a sense of humility that show me the way.
Crazy idiot.
Look, guys, all jokes aside, the fact is, Nash wanted to go to a team, he can win a title. Mavs didn't have it. Knicks didn't have it. The Raptors definitely don't have it. Stick to hockey, Canada. Lakers are it, people. This is a title contender. Look, second straight season we got out in the second round of the playoffs, right? What do we need? A point guard. Everyone keeps talking about, we need a point guard. Now, people messed up. What do you need? We don't need someone to keep up with Westbrook. You don't need speed. You need intelligence. You need someone who can distribute the ball, and that's what we have. We have four all-star caliber players. Four. We'll be all right. I got to pose a question to you. It's not a simple one. Everyone keeps talking about, what do you want, Dwight Howard or Andrew Bynum? A lot of things to think about, people, and this is where I need your help. Do we still go after Dwight Howard? Does getting Nash make Dwight Howard want to come to us more? Because we all know Kobe talked to Dwight, and they didn't really agree on how the team would be with them together. So Dwight Howard doesn't even want to sign an extension. Do you get the number one center in the league who doesn't want to be with you for more than a year? Or do you keep Andrew Bynum, who doesn't get the ball, and he gets mad, and he starts pouting, and he has an attitude problem, he's inconsistent? What do we do? What's the best for the Lakers' future? Tell me, people. Please help me out. And we both know they're both drama queens, so which one would you rather have? Bynum? Howard? That's it this week. Lakers Nation, thanks for watching. Let's be honest. I'm your host, Pretty Shaw. And make sure you catch me on Twitter, at Funny Shaw, at Butalia Media. Make sure you get him. Look how good they make me look on camera. Come on, you know he's the best. Make sure you get him for weddings, any events you have, graduation. He's the guy to hire. Check us out next week and make sure you comment. Dwight Bynum. See you guys next week.